Welcome everybody tonight. I'm so happy that you can join me. We got Matt Glenna is coming up as my special guest. And so this is Couch Concert with Quarantine with Kristine. So, oh, actually I see him. So let me get this and we'll get Matt on here.
There we are. How's it going? Hey, Kristine.
Hey, I'm so happy you can join me tonight. Like I said, it's been fun. I was just kind of welcoming everybody. We got a lot of people jumping on, so that's pretty neat. So how's your day been going so far?
Oh, it's been fantastic. I actually just got back from riding dirt bikes all day up in Mora, Minnesota, and it was great. Track was good. Lots of guys showed up and just had enough time to unload and set up some sound equipment to play a little music with you.
Oh, good. Well, I'm happy. Sounds like it. So what's the weather like then?
Oh, it's beautiful. We're sitting at about 70 right now. A little bit of a breeze and clear skies.
Nice. Well, that sounds gorgeous. Yeah, it was a nice day here today too, and going good. So, well, sweet. Well, yeah, let's see. As everybody's jumping on, feel free to say hey, and we'll keep track of the comments. So if anybody's got questions or anything, we can do that. But
like
I guess
Steve's watching. Hey, Steve.
Yeah, we got Steve. Awesome. Yeah, I know. I always have to remember to scroll too. So, you know, if anybody's jumping on and I missed you, I apologize.
This is all new to me.
Yeah. Well, that's good. Well, it'll be fun. So awesome. We got Annie on and everything. Hey, everybody. So, well, we came here for some music. Do you want to start off with a song for us and just tell us a little bit about it, or if it's one of your favorites, or however you'd like to introduce it?
Yeah, for sure. I'd start out with a song by Everlast. I think it's definitely one of my favorites. Has a little bit of a story about a truck driver who's, you know, always away from home and rushing to get back to the family. And yeah, it's called White Trash Beautiful. So I could
nice
for you if you want, but yeah. I'll fire up. I got my looper pedal with me tonight. You can't see it, but I got my drums and a little setup. So I hope it's not too loud. I turned it down quite a bit, so hopefully it sounds all right. But we'll give her a shot if you guys are ready.
Yeah, let's get some music going. It sounds good so far. So like you say, we'll give it a test run.
All right. Well, this will be a test run here. So here we go. White trash, beautiful trailer park queen. This thing's half shattered down from 11 to 5. She buried them both from school. So cool, but all he can do for money is drive out late Holly Tree on Interstate 5, praying he'll see home before his baby arrives. White trash, beautiful, something you should know. Something you
Sounds okay for them, but I was it sounded good here, so that was awesome. Loved it.
Blowing anybody's eardrums.
No, it's good on my end. So as long as everybody, it looks like people are giving thumbs up, and we lots of people are joining too. So that's pretty neat. I saw Bob, and So hi Bob. I know he said hi Kristine and everything, but So this is Bob said sounded good. Everybody's saying sounds great. Awesome. So. You are good to go.
Okay, that was a sound check, so I'm glad it worked out.
Well, it was good. Well, it sounded great. Now, I don't have all the fancy little loop pedals like you do, so I just got an acoustic.
What song were you going to play for us?
Let's see. I'm going to start off with a favorite of mine right now. So currently Ingrid Andress has one out called More Hearts Than Mine. And I just love this, the songwriting of this one and everything. So I thought that it would be fun to start off with that one. So hopefully everybody enjoys, and yeah, let me know how it sounds on your end too. So.
I grew up and walk around the foothills of my town. Probably feel like you've been there before after hearing all the stories I've been telling you for 6 months now. Probably had to sleep in separate bedrooms. Pack a shirt for church because we'll go. And I'm not trying to scare you off, but I just thought that we could talk a few things out before we hit the road. 'Cause if I bring you home to mama, I guess I better warn you, she falls in love a little faster than I do. breaker, I'll be fine. But you'll be breaking more hearts than mine. My sister's gonna ask a million questions and say anything she can to turn you red. When you meet my high school friends, they'll buy you drinks and fill you in on all the crazy nights I can't outlive. So if I'll bring you home tomorrow, I guess I better warn you, she falls in love a little faster than I do. And my dad will check your tires, pour your whiskey over ice, and buy you dinner, but pretend that he don't like you. Oh, if we break up, I'll be fine, but you'll be breaking more hearts than mine. I better warn you, she feels every heartache I go through. And if my dad sees me crying, he'll pour me whiskey over ice and tell a lie, say he never really liked you. Oh, if we break up, I'll be fine, but you'll be breaking more hearts than mine. Yeah, you'll be breaking more hearts than mine.
All right.
Awesome. Well, it sounds like it's good sound on both ends, so that's good. We're good to go then. Awesome. Well, cool. So I know that for myself, I write songs, and I know you've written some songs too, Matt. I always get the question, like, where people get inspirations from writing songs. Where does yours come from?
Most of the time, I'll find a melody that I come across, or just make up or something, and kind of go from there. And I don't know. I guess it depends on what kind of mood I'm in too. If it's going to be a happy song, or a sad song, or song about hard times. But a lot of times seems like most of my songs kind of tend to be a little darker or depressing, I guess. I don't know, but I'm really a happy person, but I don't know where the stuff comes from. I write it down and turns into a song. I think they work out pretty good, but
definitely. Well, and I think too, it's the emotion, right? Like you say, you feel an emotion, or you just kind of know something, or whatever probably you're playing on your guitar is what starts to come through.
Definitely a lot of emotion. And times in my life, or I guess if, we're trying to get through the days and keep on keeping on, I try to write motivating music to keep myself going, and something that's fun to play at the same time, and hopefully eventually get it all recorded on an album. But then that's down the road.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Yeah.
Well, cool. Well, would you mind playing us an original? Do you happen to have one that you'd like to play?
Sure. Yeah, I'm trying to think which one. I think I'd probably do let's see if I'm in tune still here.
Oh no.
Kind of played her a little hard, but yeah, I could do an original. Let's see which one.
Hi, Lon, and everybody joining us. Yeah, people, everybody, feel free to let us know where you're watching from too. That's always fun to know, what part of the country you're all tuning in from, and say hi. So sorry, keep going.
this is a song called "I've Been Saved," and I wrote it probably a year ago. And it's just kind of, I don't know, it's a pretty fast moving song, and I guess I'll just have to listen to it. I don't know what to say about it really, but yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Little things in living that get you through a day. You can save yourself a fortune if you listen to what I say. I'm not talking about money now, I'm talking about the way you live. I'm talking about love and how much you give. I ain't no preacher man, but I've been preached to in my day. I didn't pay much attention in school, but I still get paid now. I been washed in the blood and the beer now. All I can say. Every day. You may look at me right now and think he don't look too strong, but let me tell you one thing, friend, I'll put you back where you belong. Oh, I'm not one to go boasting on choosing my own horn. This here is America, that's right where I was born. Now I've been saved, been putting in blood, sweat, and tears on every day.
I think that's kind of has to do with a little bit of American pride and, you know, being proud of what you are and all that. So
awesome. Now, for people who are like joining us and stuff, where can they find either more about you or once quarantine's over, where they can maybe see you come play live or things like that?
Yeah, definitely catch me on Facebook. Right now, I'm on my regular old Instagram, so you're going to see a lot of dirt bike pictures, which that's a big part of my life. I grew up racing and riding with friends and traveling around Minnesota and worked as a mechanic on dirt bikes and four-wheelers for 3 years in Cambridge, Minnesota. So that's a big part of my life, as well as my family, and driving truck as well. That's my regular job. But yeah, definitely check out Matt Glenna Entertainment on Facebook, and I'll have to get on Instagram and make a music account on here eventually. But for the time being, this will have to do.
Awesome. Awesome. And you put like some of your videos on Facebook too. So like little tidbits or snippets of music, so they can find that there as well.
Oh yeah. I think I probably got at least 12 to 15 songs on Facebook right now for videos. And
sweet. Well, good. Awesome. Well, hey Wesley, sorry. I saw him join. So good to see you. Well, just a reminder to everybody as well who's watching, Matt and I do have a virtual tip jar going. And so if you just click in the upper part of the screen where our names are.
Yeah.
Sorry, I was loading.
I lost you for a second. Are you good?
Oh, no worries. I was just reminding everybody that we have a virtual tip jar going. So if anybody would like to tip us tonight for our performances, just click on our names and go to my profile. Click the link. We're splitting the tips tonight. And so just go to the links in my bio on Instagram. And it's not required, but always appreciated. And so we're just so happy that everybody's joining us tonight. And it's been a good weekend so far. And so hope you all are enjoying some music. So. Well, since you did an original, Matt, I'm going to do an original as well. I'm going to do my song Someday.
Yeah.
This song you can find on Spotify. I'm on Spotify, and so just search Kristine Wriding and you'll find me. But this is probably like one of my favorite songs off my album, my most recent album. And it's pretty much anybody who has a dream. It's for anybody who has a dream. It's called Someday, and it's I'm going to get there someday. And, you know, there's big mountains to climb and lots of people who maybe doubt what you're doing. But this song is one to kind of just say, keep at it and keep going. And we're all going to get there someday. So hope you all enjoyed this. This is a little Someday for y'all.
I may not know where this path may be leading. I'm gonna get there someday. There are people who say the grass is greener if I just follow their ways. But I'm as stubborn as hell, learn to fight for myself. I give a damn what others may say. I've traveled a long road, it may take me longer, but I'm gonna get there someday. Someday, yeah, yeah. Someday, yeah, yeah. Someday, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna get there someday. Dreams, they are big, but my faith is bigger, and I'm gonna get there someday. On him I am leaning, and I keep believing, work through the trials and the change. I learn from mistakes, try to rise above the pain and the fears that constantly replay. They think I'm foolish, that I just can't do this, but I'm gonna get there someday. Someday, yeah, yeah. Someday, yeah, yeah. Someday, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna get there someday. Up on this mountain, I'll look at all my doubters and smile, 'cause I told you someday I'd get where I'm going. I had fears not knowing, but pushed through, did it anyways. Paid a lot of heavy tolls to achieve this goal, 'cause to win, you can't play it safe. Did I do this on my own? There are those greatly old who believe when I told them someday. Someday, yeah, yeah. Someday, yeah, yeah. Someday, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna get there someday.
It's so hard to not sing harmony with you. That's one of my favorites of yours.
Oh, well, thank you. I know, and that's what it's always so hard, like, split screen, too, because we talked about that, like,
yeah.
Would it work, would it not? Probably not.
Yeah, not worth the risk.
Exactly. Yeah, there'd probably be some little glitch and we'd be like a half a second off and people would be like, what's going on?
I thought these guys could play.
Yeah. Well, speaking of playing, actually, Matt, how long have you been playing guitar? Oh, I think it's loading again. Hang tight with us. We'll get there. I appreciate everybody who's joining. Hopefully I'm still live here. But yeah, we'll get them back here. It's just good old internet, right? Probably everybody's on tonight. There we go. Maybe. Oh no, it's still loading. He's probably working on it. No worries. So, well, I appreciate, like I said, everybody who's joining tonight. This has been great. Let's see. I see some new people jumping on, which I'm so happy you're on. Hey, there you're back.
I got you off the Wi-Fi. We switched to 4G. I figured it'd be a little better. So.
Sure. Well, good. Well, anyways, that's all. It's all good. That's what all technology is all about. But how long have you been playing? And like, do you play multiple instruments? Like, tell us a little bit about.
Mostly guitar. I grew up actually when I was 7 years old. Started out with piano lessons, which I was forced to do as a kid. My parents wanted me to be musical, and so I did 3 years of piano lessons, and then I figured out I wanted to play guitar. Well, before I wanted to play guitar, I wanted to play drums, but my dad talked me out of it because it's just so much to carry around, the whole drum kit and everything. He's like, yeah, you're better off just playing guitar. So I ended up getting one at 10 years old, and my grandpa had a big influence on that. He's been playing guitar his whole life and had a big influence on me learning how to play bluegrass and country music with him and all my other relatives that play. And we've been playing. I took lessons on and off with for guitar maybe 2 to 3 years, got the gist of it, and then kind of took off from there. It's been picking away ever since. And I've also took mandolin lessons. I play a little mandolin. I can play an upright bass or a regular electric bass. And that's about the gist of that. I've been playing for 16 years now.
Wow. So, well, man of many talents then.
Yeah. Stay busy. Stay on track.
Well, cool. Well, how about another song from you then? Whatever you'd like to play. Let's hear another tune.
Yeah, I'll put her in drop B for this. This is another trucking song. It's called Chicken Lights and Chrome. So a lot of these trucks got all the lights down the trailer. If you ever go down the highway and you see one at night that's just lit up, we call those chicken lights, because if you go under a low bridge or something, you're supposed to look and, you know, see if you're gonna clear. But if you're chicken, you look. But she's a two-stack man with a bunk in the back. She's grown. She's got a screaming cat that won't hold back. Some hammer down boys let her go. She's a lady of the night with her chicken lights and just a couple hundred or so. Like it lost in the lines and the way she winds that FM radio. And DJ play me a song, one about trucking all night long. I got a girl that's waiting at home for me. This old rig, she sure is fast. Spinning them tires, she goes past. Long haul truckers, all I'll let be. Chicken lights and chrome, till I'm in it. You can see us coming from a billion miles away. Lights up the sky like a 4th of July. Trucker's favorite song, we all bounce along and chicken lights and chrome. But
She's lipstick red. Yeah, she'll knock them dead. And she grows scams. I let the black smoke pour as I roll on the gold now, blazing on the trail. You can bet all eyes out on 65 will have to hide from the shine. She's too damn bright, there's nowhere to hide. She's burning up the night. Chicken lines and pools, tell her I'm in good. You can see us coming from a million miles away. She lights up the sky like the 4th of July. Truckers' favorite song, Alabama's rolling on and chicken lines and groans. Truckers' favorite song, Alabama's rolling on and chicken lines and groans.
Woo! I like that one. It's got a good groove to it.
Yeah, I don't think you've heard that one yet.
No, that was a brand new one.
For sure. Yeah, I've been practicing a little bit when I can.
Awesome. Well, that's always a good thing. I know it's hard to squeeze everything in of, like you say, practice doing. And you're obviously still working during the stay-at-home. So.
For sure. Yeah. People need their freight. So I know. Keeping busy. Probably get about 50 hours a week or so. And just consistent.
Oh, my goodness.
So.
Well, we thank you for that. Like you say, thank you so much for keeping out there and keeping things moving. Because, not everybody can just, stop what they're doing. So
just doing my job.
Yep. Well, that's good. Awesome. Well, speaking of kind of a cool little groove sort of thing, I was going to sing a song called Funky Little Groove. Now, it doesn't have as cool of a groove that you have, but I was like, hey, it might go pretty well right after that. So, so this one, like I said, is called Funky Little Groove. And I actually, I do a lot of songwriting for other artists as well as myself. And so this one I wrote with Jake Owen in mind, actually. So he kind of had that beachy kind of vibe, funky groove to him. And so I wrote this one, but he didn't, pick it up or anything like that. Like, never got to him, but I still like to play it out and have some fun with it. So hopefully everybody enjoys this. This is Funky Little Groove. Staring at a picture of you on the white sand, in your swing trunk chasing those cool blue waves. I take a look at the clock, did the time stop? 'Cause I've been dreaming of you all day. Life's been killing my peace. Two pairs of shades and some sunscreen. Make the weekend last, 'cause it goes too fast and it all feels like a daydream. Life's been killing my peace. Happiness taking a back seat. Mixtape will do whatever it takes. groovy songs. Okay. Well, cool. Well, you know, thinking about playing out live and things like that, is there ever a popular requested song that you happen to get or one that you enjoy playing, like whenever it's requested?
Yeah, usually it's something I don't know how to play is what I get requested, but...
Isn't that the truth? Yep.
Well, I'll have to add that to the to-do list. I'm sorry. But yeah. Oh, man, I guess Johnny Cash is pretty popular when I'm playing at bars. Everyone likes Johnny Cash, it seems like, and I know a couple of his tunes. And, what would it be? Yeah. I don't know. A few of them.
Probably Ring of Fire. That's always a popular one.
The one about
Folsom Prison?
Folsom Prison. Yeah, couldn't say the name. That's definitely one that I've played a bunch.
Yeah. Well, that's cool.
Any songs you get requested frequently?
Yeah, like a lot of it always seems like a Kelsey Ballerini or a Taylor Swift was for a while. I don't know. I think I was playing like some different like kind of festival-y, kind of like an Apple Festival and a Lavender Festival, and I would get like a Taylor Swift Shake It Off or something, and I was like, so I learned that one. But Miranda and Carrie Underwood, that seems like a popular one too, whether it be like 4-H Cheats or Dirty Laundry, right? Yeah, I think that's the one. So that's always it's always interesting, but most of the time, like you say, it's something where I'm like, ooh, I know the chorus, and let me look it up real quick, and I might be able to get it to you. So.
Yeah, I feel so bad when I can't please the crowd, but I do my best.
I know, it is. It's a hard one, but cool. But, well, how about another song, whatever you'd like to sing, and we'll sit back and enjoy. And remember, everybody, you can tip us tonight. It's a virtual tip jar, so just click our names up in the corner and then click the link in my bio, and all the tips we're going to split tonight. And so feel free to tip. It's not required, but always appreciated.
Get my drums set up here.
Yeah.
This is an original I wrote a couple months ago. It's I don't know. I guess you could call it hip or hick hop. Kind of country rap a little bit. But
sweet.
We'll give her a shot. Soon, so we're gonna get her going here. I'll just start over.
It's all good. That's the beauty of life.
Sorry about that. My head, yeah, I walked to the kitchen, brewed me up a pie.
want it real strong. I try to clear my thoughts, but I can't tell you why. I can't tell you when, but I know I've been down, and so have all my friends. Yeah, we try real hard, we do our best, trying to fly the coop, but we stuck in the nest. We're from the woods, not from the hood. We don't steal cows, we work real hard with the dirt on our hands. We sweat for a dollar, so we can get rednecks and blue collars, America's smile and meet my friends. We'll swim, tease a bitch, our heart beats. Tomorrow's a new day, we gonna be around. You know, the 16 and the sun's gonna shine, yeah, the sun's gonna shine. The sun's gonna shine. Put on your shades and crank up the ship. Load the box by hand, cause it ain't that heavy gun. Rail some rugs and hold the throttle wide. It's the only way gonna know to get relief from life. Well, my stress is gone, wave goodbye. No bouncing dogs in my careless mind. Boy, strap up your boots and buckle up your helmet. You better hold on tight, cause we're just gonna set it. We're from the woods, not from the hood. We don't steal cars, we work real hard with the dirt on our hands. We sweat for our dollars, sun's beating down on rednecks and blue collars. America's my land, for me and my friends. When he's a bench at my heart can't. Tomorrow's a new day, we gonna be fine. Tune up to the 16 and the sun's gonna shine. Yeah, the sun's gonna shine. The sun's gonna shine.
Need to put together an album and get a lot of this music out. It sounds amazing.
A couple more originals, I might have enough for I think I only have like seven or eight originals, but that could be a short album, I suppose. What's a normal album, like 12 songs or?
Yeah, it's usually like 10 to 12, but right now everybody's doing EPs, so you could totally do like EPs are usually like 5, and then you can kind of release singles. So if you wanted to, you could kind of record 5 of them and like every month release one, or every 2 months. There's kind of like a little schedule thing, but that's always, it's always fun because it keeps the music fresh and people coming back for more. So
yeah, that'd be awesome.
Yeah, sweet.
To a couple recorded studios or something.
Definitely. Yes. Yes. So, and you had a lot of people saying, like, sounds awesome. You are amazing. Like, you have a lot of great, yeah, he's awesome. Love the lyrics and the melody, the beat. So you have lots of fans.
Yeah, definitely check out my Facebook page, Matt Glenna Entertainment, and give her a thumbs up. I got a couple other originals and, like I said, covers on there. And I always try to keep an update on when I'll be playing next. And as of now, with the whole stay at home in effect or whatever, obviously the bars aren't open. So I really have nowhere to play unless it's like a private party, but that's just hasn't been happening. But I can't wait for it to get back to normal and get out there and start playing gigs again.
Yes, I agree with that, because yeah, it's kind of a bummer that all of a sudden it's like, oh, that's why everybody started going virtual, and so at least we can do this to do a little something.
Yeah,
that's cool. Well, last time I did one of these, it kicked us off in an hour. So looking at the time, I think we could probably do like one more each, which I think would be pretty good, and then wrap things up. But yeah, it was all of a sudden we were like going to be playing another song, and it was like, your live is ending in 5 seconds. And it was like, oh, okay. So we'll try to, I guess, obey Instagram's rules here, but you know.
Sure.
But, well, cool. Well, I'll do my final song then. And like I said, we can wrap it up, but everybody, thank you so much for tuning in and watching. There's been awesome people. Nyla said, Matt, you got a great voice, which is sweet. I totally agree. I love everything, your voice and guitar playing and all that good stuff. So be sure to follow us on socials, everybody. And we're, like you say, Matt's on Facebook, Matt Glenna Entertainment, and me, Kristine Wriding. Pretty much Google my name and you can find me. But websites, Facebook, Instagram, all that good stuff. Obviously Instagram, because we're on this right now. But but we'll end this little live here. I'm going to do a Billy Currington song. This is one of my favorites that I just love to sing and play. And usually it gets a chuckle out of everybody. It's People Are Crazy. Oh, yeah. And, you know, I love this song because there's three things in life that I've learned. And it's God is great, beer is good, and people are crazy. And so this one's always a fun one. So here we go.
This old man be that far and weak. Having us some beers and swapping I don't cares. Talking politics, lawn and redhead chicks, old dogs and new tricks and habits we ain't kicked. We talked about God's grace and all the hell we raised. And then I heard the old man say, God is great, beer is good, and people are crazy. He said, I'll fall to the wolves, been married and divorced. What brings you to Ohio? He said, damn if I know. We talked an hour or two, but every boy we knew what all we put them through, like two old folks would do. Parted life and death, he lit a cigarette, said these damn things will kill me, yes. But God is great, beer is good, people are crazy. But last call is 2 a.m. I said goodbye to him and never talked to him again. Then one sunny day, I saw the old man's face, front page obituary. He was a millionaire. left his fortune to some girl he barely knew. His kids were mad as hell. For me, I'm doing well. And I stop by today to just say thanks and pray. And I left a six pack right there on his grave. And I said, God is great, beer is good, and people are crazy. God is great, beer is good, and people are crazy. Yeah. God is great, beer is good, and people are crazy.
Always a good one.
One of my favorites. I think I always mess up the bridge when I try and find that chord, the minor chord, and it just never works.
Yes, yes. I know, it always throws you too, because the whole song is like that consistent chord pattern, and then it's all of a sudden like, oh no.
But you nailed it. Great job.
Oh, well, thank you. But, well, how about a final song from you?
Okay, we can do that. We'll go old school, see if my yodeler works here.
Uh-oh. That'll be fun.
Yeah, something different. No, I guess just got done rapping. I might as well yodel. So something.
Yeah.
Some things are pushing it for me on my comfort scale.
Well, it's pretty good if you can yodel. I don't think I can. I've never actually tried, but I don't think it'd probably sound too good.
Something like that. Don't laugh. I might mess up.
No worries.
I went down to the river to watch the fish swim by. But when I got to the river, the doggone river was dry. And so I jumped in the river, but the doggone river was dry. She's alone. I had me a woman, couldn't be true. She made me for my money, and she made me blue. A man needs a woman, and he can lean on. I'm gonna find me a river, one that's cold as ice. And when I find me that river, Lord, I'm gonna be the bride for Lord. I'm going down in a green town, but Lord, I'm only coming up a ways. She's a
awesome.
Brilliant there.
That's great. Now, is that like kind of some of your musical influences then, or like who did you listen to growing up?
Yeah, definitely Hank Williams and, you know, Senior, Junior, and I don't know if you guys have heard about the Third, but he's playing some cool stuff too. Definitely those three, and lots of rock and roll influences, blues, Stevie Ray Vaughan, Jimi Hendrix, played the biggest part in my guitar playing, I think, after I learned how to play. I saw a video of Stevie playing Pride and Joy, one of his popular songs, and like, man, I just really want to play like that someday, and I'm getting there. I can sit down and pick a couple licks here and there, but definitely never going to be that level. But yeah, lots of country influence, rock and roll, blues, and a little bit of bluegrass.
Sweet. No, that's awesome. It's neat to have all those influences kind of come into one, because you can tell that it's just like a part of you, you know, which makes it so unique too.
Yes. Yeah. Makes me who I am. All the music I listen to, it's a vast variety. Anything from, oh man, like some rap and hip hop to good old fashioned bluegrass.
Yeah.
Anything in
that's music. Good. Sweet. Well, somebody said nice yodel skills. Actually, Andrew said that. So that was great. We had him on last week.
Thanks, Andrew. I tried.
It did. It sounded great. So, well, like I said, I'll wrap this up before Instagram kicks us off. But it was a great time. I want to remind everybody that we have a virtual tip jar going. So if you feel free to leave a tip, it's not required, but appreciated. Just go to the link in my bio and you can leave a tip. But I'm going to have some more of these come in the next 2 weeks. So next week on the 8th, I have Dallas Remington. And the week after on a Friday, the 15th, I have Mitch Gordon. So that's going to be really fun. And we appreciate Matt joining us tonight and showing off his awesome skills and everything like that. And you can find Matt on Matt Glenna Entertainment on Facebook, and then Kristine Wriding. You can find Facebook and Instagram and Twitter and all that stuff. But I think I covered it all. Anything? Sorry, Matt. I don't mean to be like talking everything.
This is your couch concert. I'm just filling in. Yeah. You're doing great. Thanks for having me again. Beautiful day up here in Minnesota, and hopefully the weather was nice down there. What was the temp today, Kristine?
Ooh, it was in the probably 70s as well. I think it got up to like 78 or something. So it's starting to warm up.
Yeah, we were right around 69, 70 up here.
That's really nice though, because like just that when it's just starting to warm up, because all of a sudden when summer hits and it gets so hot, you're like, oh man, where did those spring days go?
I hear you there.
Well, cool. Well, awesome. Well, I think we got all the questions and comments. Again, everybody, thank you so much for joining us, and hope you all have a wonderful night and stay healthy and safe. And we'll like probably do this again sometime down the road, because it's always a fun thing.
Hopefully in person together, maybe we'll be able to.
Yes. Yeah. That would be fun. Mm-hmm, that would be the best.
But yes. Stay safe down there. Thanks for having me, Kristine, and have a great night.
All right, you too. We'll see y'all later.
Take it easy.
Bye.